Many of you may know the old expression, seeing is believing. And in our modern day culture, many of us abide by that saying to a great degree. But today's lessons speak the opposite of that, speak the opposite of seeing is believing, and begins with the very first reading from the Acts of the Apostles. Peter, in this reading, is speaking at the day of Pentecost. This is one of his first speeches about who Jesus is and about how Jesus' resurrection has changed the world. And Peter speaks about a psalm we actually sang as well in our liturgy this morning. And Peter says, attributing that psalm to David, how that psalm describes that the power of death will ultimately be broken, that God's Holy One will not see the corruption of the grave. And knowing that David and all of his ancestors and descendants up until this point have died, Peter says, David knew something that we don't. David saw something that was not evident in front of his eyes. Somehow, the author of the psalm, whom Peter believes was David, saw God's power extending beyond the grave, saw God's power bringing about a new life in the world and for the people of God. David, or the author of the psalm, whoever he might have been, did not see, but believed. And the same thing is true for the recipients of the letter of Peter, from which we read this morning. And in that epistle, the author is very clear. You have not seen Jesus, and yet you love him. These are people who have probably never even seen Jesus in the flesh, either before or after the resurrection. And yet somehow, those who told them about Jesus, those who initiated them into the community of Christ, showed them something that gave them hope, showed them something that gave them the realization that something new was happening, that new life could begin. They did not see with their eyes, but they believed. And of course, in the reading from the gospel for this morning, we kind of get a little bit convoluted lesson. Because if you look at it, Thomas, who we constantly criticize for his incredulity, Thomas was not the only one who saw before he believed. The other disciples, too, when Jesus first appears to them, Jesus says to them, showing them his hands and his side, peace be with you, and he shows them his hands and his side. Every disciple in this reading, not just Thomas, first see and then believe. But then at the end, Jesus says this final benediction. Blessed are those who have not seen and yet have come to believe. The author of the gospel is talking about us. We have not seen Jesus in the flesh, like the recipients of the letter of Peter. Neither before nor after his resurrection have we seen Jesus with our physical eyes. And yet somehow, we have come to believe. And I think one of the ways we might think about this is to take that old cliche, seeing is believing, and turn it on its head. And think for a moment about what it might mean to say, believing is seeing. Believing is seeing. Now, what do I mean by that? Well, what I mean is that when we give our hearts to God, when we open ourselves to the spiritual power of Jesus' resurrection, then we may begin to look at the world with new eyes, and we may begin to the signs of God's work, the signs of God's new life everywhere we go. Look outside. It's slow in coming and hither and yon, but spring is coming. And the flowering spring, the beauty of the flowers on our very altar, for those who have eyes to see, are a sign of God's power, are a sign of the resurrection, are a sign of new life. And among ourselves, in many ways, we also have seen signs of new life. This parish itself has seen signs of new life in the wonderful coming together of people from different countries of the world, of coming together of those who were persecuted, of coming together to build a new life and a new family in Christ. That too is the work of God. That too is the power of Jesus' resurrection. And we are continuing to be called to see the signs of God's resurrection power among us, to see the signs of God's love whenever we give of ourselves for Christ, whenever we give to others in the name of Christ, whenever we pledge ourselves and commit ourselves to the love of God in Christ. That's the beginning of new life. That's the beginning of new hope. That's the resurrection power in and among us. Blessed are those who have not seen and yet have come to believe. In the name of God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit.